Hi there. I'm calling on the customer education team here at Asana. And if you work on a team that handles requests, you know that the difference between a stressed, reactive team and a calm, organized one often just comes down to how well they handle incoming requests. Today, I'll walk through Asana's request tracking workflow that will help your team streamline any request process. I'll start by showing a request tracking project in motion at Phoenix Corps. Then I'll give a step-by-step walkthrough on setting up your own request tracking project. So we will start by seeing a request tracking project in motion at Phoenix Corps. And first, we're going to go ahead and meet the key players in that workflow. This project is managed by the operations team at Phoenix Corps. And Neha is an operations team member that often handles new requests. Jamie is a team manager that makes approvals. And Alan is a member of the marketing team that is submitting an approval request. Okay, so here I am in the project and there's a few things to note. Tasks represent existing requests throughout the company. There are three views available in this workflow. All requests, that includes all requests in the project, my assigned request that contains only requests assigned to me. In this case, I am Neha. And finally, a performance dashboard that includes key reporting data about total requests created, request count by assignee, lots of really helpful data here. Tasks in this project, there are grouped into five project phases. Not started, for requests that have recently been submitted and not actioned on. In progress for requests that are being actively worked on. Pending, these may be awaiting an approval or final sign-off, and completed requests. There is one more, the fifth one. Requests can also be deferred as needed. From the Customize menu, I can see that custom fields as well as rules have been added to this project, and I'm going to highlight these more in the demo. So, all of these features that I just talked through, these will come pre-packaged when you build your project, and it's up to you to edit and customize them to your liking. Okay, so intake for this workflow is done with an Asana form. So Alan, who needs to submit the marketing request, gets the link to the form and fills out his request that's for deliverable. And the summary is that it's about a marketing email series for the new set of security features. He adds more description about the request. Then he submits the form. Okay, so back in the project, again, logged in as Neha. The Alan's request has appeared as a task in the project. And this is a good time when there's other requests in the project to narrow in on the work assigned to you and go to My Assigned Requests. Clicking into this task, in the task description, I will see all the form details are in here. But a number of other things have also happened, and I'm actually going to move this field here. Custom fields have been filled in, first off. Okay, so the request type is a deliverable for an email series. The ID field has been filled in. This is really like a unique identifier for each request. And then the two timers associated with this project have started. So the resolution timer, which tracks the time until the request is resolved, and the first response timer, which tracks the time until a team member, in this case Neha, responds to the request the first time. They're both green, meaning that they're running. If these were grayed out, that would mean that the request was submitted outside of working hours, and they wouldn't start running until the working hours started. Additionally, two AI-powered rules have run on this task. One renamed the task title to be really actionable and described the request more effectively. And two, I'll click on the comment here. A second AI-powered rule assessed the request to see if it had enough information. This request did not. There was missing information about the due date, or the time frame for when the marketing email series should be completed. Neha wants to ensure that Alan Ute sees these questions, so what she'll do is she will copy and paste them, send that comment to him, and make sure it's sent to his email. Posting the comment will make it appear that way, showing it's in an email. One other thing to call out is that will move the requests to in progress. And the impact that will have on the first response timer is it will pause it. And so she responded pretty darn quickly, well under the maximum amount of time, and that will be reflected in the performance dashboard. Okay, so now I am in Alan's email inbox, which is pretty weird looking and stress inducing. But I will click into this email, and in here it says replies to this email will automatically be added to your request. And I can see the question here about the due date. And so Alan will respond by replying with the dates. And now you'll see that there's a third comment that's been added about September 25th being that deadline. Over the following days, Neha would probably need to take on some work about this email series and really scoping it out that I won't show here. But let's say Neha is feeling really good about this request and changes its status to complete. The request disappeared. Don't worry, you could still find it. This is just only showing incomplete tasks. And so if you showed completed tasks as well, there it would be right there. And the last thing to touch on here is that the resolution timer would stop immediately once it's been completed and moved to this phase of the workflow. So I've walked through the Phoenix Corp's request tracking workflow in action. Now it's time for the fun part, where we're going to get to set up a marketing request tracking project from scratch. And during this time, really feel free to build along with me. Okay. So to create a new project, I will go to create project, and I want to use a template from the library. You'll see right here, it populates right at the top, the request tracking template. If you have some more recently other used ones, you could certainly find it within Find Inspiration as well. Within this, I can see a quick paragraph describing the template. More importantly, right here, we can see everything that comes prepackaged within this template, from the different timers to three AI-powered rules. Everything that's in there is covered right there. So I'll use this template and rename the project Marketing Request Tracking and then create it. As the project is being generated, it's just adding all of the features you just saw on that details page, so it may take a little bit of time, but not too long. Okay, so here I am in the project, which looks quite similar to the Phoenix Corp's one I just demoed. Asana automatically opens up the customize menu with the steps to finish setting up the request tracking project and really tailor it to my team's needs. So I'll work through these steps to optimize the workflow for my marketing team. The first step is to edit the form. This request form is how the team will intake new marketing requests, and the template to start is really simple, but it's also entirely customizable. I'll start by renaming this to Marketing Request Form, just to mirror the project name. Then I'll pay special attention to this request type question. This is linked to the request type custom field in the project, and it helps categorize the different types of requests that people might submit. The template includes four options, but you can add more as needed or adjust accordingly. So I'll add a option for request for consult, maybe move it above other, and then go ahead and save the changes. And so something that's really important to call out here too is these custom fields are included in the AI-powered rules in this project. And so since I customized this field, I changed it from what was prepackaged, I'll need to update the rule at a later step. I like the rest of the questions. One other one that I will add really quickly is just a date field to ensure that requesters include this. So requested date. Okay, and I've selected date, and I could connect this to the due date in the project. That's enough for now. I'll now transition over to the form settings to call out a few key points. So the access to this form is set to organization only, which enables email communication with the form submitter. In fact, anyone with this link, even if they didn't have an Asana account, if they're in your organization, they could submit it and they could also respond with their email. Form submitters are also added as collaborators. This really helps allow for direct communication on the task. But if you'd prefer to turn this off, the default is on, but if you'd prefer to turn it off to allow for private conversations on tasks, that's easy to do. Okay, so I will go ahead and save this. And that will automatically advance me to the second step, which is to edit the task template. And here we can see the project phases here. These are pre-populated with five, but you can always edit or remove existing options and add new ones. For example, I can edit pending to be pending manager. Then I'll remove deferred. Maybe that's not an option in my team's workflow. And add a phase instead for rejected. Red is a appropriate color for that. And then also get to determine if something is marked as rejected, does that mean the request is complete or incomplete? In this case, that would mean it was complete. Okay. The third step is to open project settings, which you can also access down here. And so within here, you can set the default type of task as well as the work schedule. The working schedule automatically defaults to the time zone of the project creator. In this case, this team is in San Francisco, so it's set for Pacific time. I'll go ahead and leave it as business days, Monday through Friday, with a standard 9 to 5 workday. And really, what this impacts is the timers, because again, they will be grayed out if someone submitted a request outside of these hours. Okay. The next few steps are really about the rules in this project and setting up the timers appropriately. So, this first one is for the resolution timer. The rule is triggered by a request or a task being added to the project. And then, depending on the request type, it sets the resolution timer to different amounts of time. Because, for example, answering a question is probably going to take less time than requesting a deliverable. And one really important thing to remember here is that I added a new request type earlier. That was request for consult. And so that needs to be reflected in this rule. And so what I'll do is I'll set an otherwise if condition and find request type is the custom field. And there's request for consult. And then I need to determine the resolution timer for that. So the change the resolution timer to, and for a consult, I'll say 2 days as well. All right, that looks good. We'll go ahead and save it. And the fifth step is about the first response timer. So I'll edit this rule again. Again, the first response timer starts right when a request is submitted and the task is added to the project. And we can see that this rule sets a 1 day target for response when a task enters the project. For most teams, responding within 1 business day represents good customer service. So I'm going to go ahead and keep this the default setting, though I could change it to hours, or a different number of days. Okay, I'll just exit out because this looks good to me. The sixth step is setting up the resolution timer behavior. In this rule, when the request moves to a different phase, we want different things to happen to the resolution timer. Okay, so for example, it starts in not started and in progress, but if it moves to phases like pending manager or complete, the resolution timer should pause. Asana also calls out that I got rid of deferred, and so that selection no longer exists. So if I click into this, I can actually replace it with rejected. And that should also pause the resolution timer. Okay, so updated that with the new field that I added in. And I'll go ahead and save. Great, so step 7 is to test out the workflow. So I will submit a form to show how work kicks off in this workflow. And while doing so, I will highlight a few of the customizations we made to the workflow. Okay. So here is a request. It's a request for consult, which is the new request type we added, about updating marketing materials for the fall launch. There's also the requested date question that I added into the form. Okay, so after submitting, the request appears in the project. The request type custom field has been filled in, as well as the unique identifier. And then both timers have been updated with the correct amount of time that we set in the rules, okay? And so over the next few days, the team would work on this and move it to in progress. Maybe it would require a manager approval and it would go there. But maybe it's something that the team couldn't end up dealing with and they decided to reject this request. After doing so, if I removed the filters and looked just into rejected, I could see that the request was completed and moved to the rejected phase. Okay, so the last step is to just continue optimizing and working on your workflow. You can make updates anytime by clicking into the customize menu to open this panel and really look into the different rules that are a part of this project. You could add new ones, make tweaks, same thing with the custom fields. And once your request tracking system has been running for some time, the performance dashboard will become a really powerful tool. Here's from the workflow that we demoed that just had a few more requests in it. And you can see useful metrics like the average resolution time, the total requests created, as well as data down below on individual team members and their number of requests. That completes our walkthrough of the request tracking project template that you can now find in Asana. So you really now have a functional and customizable system to help your team manage incoming requests effectively. Thanks for watching and head to the Asana Academy to learn more.